So, honest opinion, what do you guys think of the new 2018 Ford F-150? The front end, I actually really like it. I know a lot of people don't really care for it, but I really like the new front end of the F-150s. I also like the non-high-end package model as well. I think both are a pretty nice improvement over the 2017 model F-150 in terms of overall appearance. If anything, I really like how they rounded out the bottom portion of the grille now versus how it kind of just went down and stopped at the bumper. But I want your opinion. What do you guys think of it? Hey everyone. So the point of this video today is to discuss a topic that a lot of people have asked me either over email, message, or in my comments. And that is, do you need a CDL to tow a fifth wheel or travel trailer in any particular state? The answer to that is not clear, simply because it varies by state. Now, what I can tell you is probably 95 to 98% of the people in the state of Texas who are towing a fifth wheel behind a dually pickup truck are towing it illegally, and they don't even know it. In the state of Texas, if the combined weight rating, not the actual weight, but the combined weight rating of your truck and your trailer exceed 26,001 pounds, you are required by law to have a Class A license, which means you need to pass the Section 14 exam and the driving course exam to tow your specific trailer on Texas highways. Now, if you are out of state and your state doesn't require that, then of course your state laws apply as you come into Texas. But if you are a resident of Texas and you are towing a fifth wheel behind a truck that the combined weight of both units, the truck and the trailer, exceed 26,001 pounds, you are required by law to have a Class A license in the state of Texas. Now, what does that mean? What that basically means is that your truck, let's say my F-450, has a gross vehicle weight rating of 14,000 pounds. Even though the truck weighs roughly 9,000 pounds by itself, the actual weight, that's not what they use to determine this calculation. It's the maximum weight your truck can have with payload and occupants in it, which in my case is 14,000 pounds. My fifth wheel is also 14,000 pounds of gross trailer weight rating. When you combine the two together, it equals 28,000 pounds. If I go to a scale, the actual weight may be less than that. It might be slightly greater than that. But what matters is the weight ratings of the vehicles. And because both of them are above the 26,001 pound threshold, I am required to have a Class A license. Now, it is not a Class A CDL. So if you think having a Class A, B, or C license is the same as having a Class A or B CDL, you would be incorrect. A CDL, or a commercial driver's license, is issued to commercial carriers only, somebody who is using their vehicle combination in the line of business or to conduct commerce. In the use case of people who are towing RVs, you would actually get an exemption status. It would be a Class A license, which means you've passed the driving exam and the written exam, which is actually a computer exam, to show that you are proficient in the laws, the safety practices, specifically the towing restrictions as far as the width, the length, as well as what you need to do in the event of a breakdown, and what you need to do for proper stopping, as well as distance, following distance, and other laws that are applicable to pulling an RV or operating equipment with an exempt status. Now, what that means is, let's say you're driving and you don't have a Class A, you have your standard Class C license in the state of Texas, and you get pulled over by a trooper or DPS agent. That means you can actually be charged with a misdemeanor, be fined, and be cited for driving without a license. So if you're involved in an accident, that might also mean that your insurance won't cover you because you can be cited for driving without a license. So regardless of what state you reside in, I want you to be sure to look at what your applicable laws are in regards to how you're able to drive and tow a vehicle in your state. Now, let's say that I had an F-250 or an F-350 single rear wheel truck that had a gross vehicle weight rating of 10,000 pounds or 11,000 pounds. Well, the combined rating of my truck and my trailer would then be under that 26,001 pound threshold, and I wouldn't be required to have a Class A license. A Class C license would be all I'd need. So before you start asking me that question, if you're hauling a fifth wheel with a truck that when you add the combination of the gross vehicle weight rating and the gross trailer weight rating together, and that gross combined weight rating does not equal 26,001 pounds, then you are perfectly legal, in the state of Texas at least, using your Class C license. But the minute you go over that 26,001 pound rating, not actual weight, but rating, you are required by law to upgrade your license to a Class A exempt license. So I just wanted to make that clear, and I'm going to put a chart up that gives you kind of the restrictions and what the requirements are in your state. A lot of people say, you know, well, I don't need a commercial driver's license to tow my RV, and that is 100% accurate. In almost every state that I'm aware of, do not need a CDL or a commercial driver's license to tow an RV or any type of recreational vehicle. However, you may be required to take additional courses as well as upgrade your license to tow the rig you have to a non-CDL version of a commercial license. So essentially, passing a test, passing a driving exam of using a heavier than normal trailer truck combination on your public roads, your highways, and your interstate system. So just wanted to make that point clear to everybody. And hopefully those of you who are towing and exceed that amount already know this and you have your Class A. But after some research, I've found that the vast majority of people who are using a modern dually truck, which most of them have between about a 13 and a 14,000 pound gross vehicle weight rating, and a fifth wheel trailer, which most of them are generally between 12 to 17,000 pounds, are going to be over that 26,001 pound threshold and therefore required to have an upgraded version of their license. And if you don't have that, you may want to look at getting it if it's required, because again, you can be cited with a misdemeanor as well as pay a heavy fine and be liable for an accident even if it's not your fault. So guys, I just want you to take this very seriously. If you have any questions or comments, I can try to answer them. I'm not going to know all the applicable laws for the specific state you may reside in, but this is something you really need to take seriously. Anyways, guys, I hope this video has been informative and helpful, and I hope it at least points you in the right direction if you now know that you need to get that upgraded license. Guys, if you like my channel, I'd appreciate it if you subscribe and give me a thumbs up. Thank you.